and clear skies here in Hallandale Beach as we settle in for the marathon-like Saturday, August 31st card here at Gulfstream Park. The calm before the storm, we'll see. Busting out the seersucker today. Nicoletti and Blewett, good to have you with us, everybody. Wherever you're watching, we certainly appreciate your company. And we
almost match.
We do almost match. Who wears it better?
We didn't plan it.
No, we did not.
Of course, me.
Yeah, indeed, you do. Respect your elders, folks. Also respect the fact, Ronnie, we've got, aside from four stakes on the card and a couple of turf races coming up a bit later in the day, we have got a Rainbow Six carryover. I mean, that really, in addition to the fact that we have one of the top, if not top two or three two-year-olds currently in the nation running later today in the form of Chance It, you've got nearly $1 million on the nose already in that Rainbow Six carryover.
Yeah, and if you're not aware, the main track is fast. The turf is good for those two-year-old stakes races a little later on, but races 1, 4, 6, and 8 have been taken off the turf, so make sure you have that in your plans when you're handicapping.
Took a while to get the odds, so we are going to have an abbreviated show here on this Saturday edition of Gulfstream Today. Ronnie and I will obviously have our my early pick five and all that stuff as the card progresses, and we'll spend some time in the moments or minutes leading up to each individual race, beginning with the first. Let's fast forward though, Ronnie, through the first seven, and we'll dive, because this is the real quality portion of the card as it stands. The Rainbow Six begins in race number 8 today. You've got four stakes in the sequence. How's the ticket looking?
Well, it's looking like it's right up there at the $64.80, and you'll just see I went four deep, and you'll look all the way down the race, 13. I'm going to be one of those that singles Chance It today. Even if Chance It doesn't run, you know, the best race of its career, I think he's good enough to beat the field that I see, at least in the air. So four deep, this one, eighth race, one of those races taken off the turf. I wanted a lot of coverage. Race number 11, a lot of people are going to like a couple of horses in there. That's what the stake. I think that the favorite in there is beatable, so I went four deep. And it cost me $86.40 is what it was.
Yeah, Chance It's probably going to be no higher than 2-5, maybe even as low as 1-5 in the co-featured 13th race finale, the Affirm Stakes for the Florida Sire Series runners. And I've got him singled in my late pick five, and he's obviously going to be a popular standalone type horse for good reason. Not the case, though, bookending this sequence with Saturday's eighth race and off the turf, 7 furlong, $10,000 3-and-up claimer that sees you and I just boxing up the deuce discreet heat. And here's the thing with the 2 and 8, the number 8 Happy Hat. We've got two new claims here, both good trainers. I am hoping, though, the good recent form with the 8 Happy Hat now moving over to Alan Iwinski, that'll carry this horse maybe even further forward this afternoon.
Yeah, he ran really well last time before he was claimed at the last bond and just walloped that field of 10 claimers going 7 furlongs, and that was on a sloppy track. And if you just look at discreet heat, 6-for-10 in the money on the fast track, 5-1-1 on the wet surface, so very versatile. And I think those are the logical two. 12, are you through in the ticket just on the drop today? But I went four deep, as you saw in my Rainbow Six ticket, just to have some coverage in there.
Now, the last non-stakes on the card goes as race number 9, but this is very much a standalone event on its own accord and in its own right. You've got a good group of 2-year-old maidens, and certainly a promising crew set to battle in the opening leg of Saturday's late pick five, a stakes-heavy sequence at 6 furlongs. Much like Ronnie's Rainbow Six ticket, I have got Chance It anchoring this entire play, a $24, in fact, sequence for 50 cents, beginning with Dream Doro and the 7 Poe. I know you like the 7 Poe. Pedigree says this horse is supposed to like the 3/4 today.
Yeah, the full brother to multiple stakes winner, Cookie Dough, and I just went off that. And, you know, I just like the horse and the position it's in. But Dream Doro was also on my ticket.
And Dream Doro, the 2, is one of a couple, in fact, who ran on that first round, that afternoon, first round of the Florida Sire Stakes already 4 weeks ago on August 3rd. And so much happened in this race, mainly to the number 3 on this particular day in Dream Doro. I just thought it would be worthwhile, although it's a lengthy replay per se, it'd be worthwhile to look at the entire trip. Again, Dream Doro is the number 3. Wickster's Dream is the number 5. He'll have a little bit of trouble steadied out in and among, but here's the first real strike to the number 3 Dream Doro, and you see the 5 Wickster's Dream outside steady ever so slightly, and he'll lose a little bit of position. It gets even worse, though, because you had that major abrupt check almost to a standstill with the 3 Dream Doro. Now the rider is sending him up inside. Maybe the horse a little timid. The 7 horses come over. You get another steady check, check, check. At this point, you're going, there's no way this horse will put in a run. Not only does he put in a run, he essentially passes the entire field while doing it with a rail-skimming ride. And do keep in mind, this is a two-year-old who had only run one prior time. He'll take the lead off the far turn. Wickster's Dream, meanwhile, after that early trouble, has a drop back, running fifth or sixth at this point. I just thought this was really, it was a trip, Ronnie, to be fair. Probably everybody saw, but boy, you couldn't have drawn up a more adversity-filled, onerous trip than the one that this colt by Congrats had.
Yeah, I mean, the trouble line reads like a small novel, and
right,
it checks, that, you know. So a logical contender in there. You had to have that one on the ticket. With a clean trip, you know that would have been the winner, I believe, in that race that we saw, of course. But I did go with Poe, as I mentioned, a full brother to that stakes winner. Cookie Dough stretching out to three quarters. He responded to both the Lasix, the Blinkers. He ran third behind who? Chance It. That was going five furlongs back on June 1st. Stanley Gold. This is his game. Two-year-olds here. This is his game. And he's got Jairo Rendon atop this son of brethren. Dream the Oro for what we just shown.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, Antonio Sano's got an American Pharoah Firster in Express Pharoah, who I have fourth. Ronnie has third in the ninth. Antonio, and we'll see if that horse ultimately is live and gets bet. Antonio will be a shorter kind of price in race number 10, the opening stakes on the card. Two-year-old fillies in the $100,000 Sharp Susan on the turf. Course condition probably going to come into play. We've obviously had quite a bit of rain here over the last few weeks, and it is listed as good, and we'll have a little bit of cut to it. That said, you've got Antonio's filly on the rail in Champagne Humor, who may like a stretch out, but the race clearly goes through Fujaira, who, boy, was she good in her turf debut.
Yeah, daughter of Gosap, or she's going to step up today to face the winners. She was really impressive, and she broke from a tough post. She stalked the pace. She drew clear to win by four lengths. She wanted play devil's advocate. She drifted a little in the stretch. I still think she's the one to beat. Now, Champagne Yuma is going to stretch out. Actually went up to Saratoga and finished third in the Bolton Landing up there. They brought this horse right back. I think it comes back. That was August 14th, so a little bit of a short turnaround for that horse. And Onyx, I threw him a ticket. We're basically right in agreement with our tribe.
Yeah, the 1-5 going in are just going to be bet in their own little category. And if you like somebody else, you're going to get a price for sure in the two-year-old filly division of the Sharp Susan. We'll stay with the youngsters, of course, but bring on the turf-bound colts and geldings in the $100,000 Proud Man as we go the 7.5 furlongs in a race. It was just the capper going back to the finale, race 13, back on that August 3rd card, Ronnie, for Safi Joseph and Shooting Star Thoroughbreds. Island Commish running away and hiding was just the icing on the cake that day.
Yeah, just ran incredible. So we'll see how this horse runs, and you see our selections up
there. I skipped the race.
Yeah.
I skipped the race. My fault there, guys. Okay. I'm glad we did the 10th. I skipped over the 11th. I just grabbed. Here we go with the field slate. I apologize for the two-year-old fillies, the Florida Sire Stakes, Susan's Girl Division. You've got, let's see, Lindsay's Lucky Lady, of course, a big favorite. She's unbeaten, and she hasn't been tested, and she's been really, really good thus far. She will face a bulky field, including two from trainer Mark Cassie, and just backtracking to the Desert Vixen here back on that August 3rd card. Same day Safi won three races. But anyway, Lindsay's Lucky Lady is in those maroon, hunter green and white Stonehenge silks towards the outside. I also want you to take a look at the Gary Barber horse in the hot pink in 260, who just didn't get a good trip. And in talking, and I'll expand a little more upon her, but, you know, Ronnie, looking at the run the seven makes now, she puts in that bold 3-4 wide slingshot move into the turn where 260 at this juncture gets hooked and kind of caught down inside. What can you say about Lindsay's Lucky Lady?
Well, she's going to stretch out to seven furlongs today, and she kept her record unblemished when she followed a victory. That was on the Seal Sloppy track. That was in the Golden Isle. She comes right back, and you're looking at this race right now, the six furlong Desert Vixen, and she's contested again on, as you can see, the sloppy conditions. She's perfect. She's never done anything wrong yet, so we'll see. Maybe with the fast conditions today. I just thought that, you know, that race didn't come up that fast, that maybe there was other ways you can go in here. Had the scratch of my long shot today, Key Biscayne, who I was looking to beat. But 260 had a little trouble in that race. You might want to use this horse on your ticket.
I loved 260's first start. I just love the way she ran, the way she did it. She ran like a horse who had already started 25 times, like a seasoned older pro. In talking to Edgar Zayas, and you'll hear a taped interview I conducted with Edgar here yesterday, a bit later on this Saturday card, Edgar said, everybody went, I just had no options. I sent her through inside. It wasn't the trip I wanted, ultimately, for 260. I'm going to give her a big excuse for that sloppy track race, hoping she can turn the tables. But again, the bar has been set higher than the others. The high watermark belongs to Lenzie's Lucky Lady, and she'll try to make it a perfect 4-for-4 this afternoon. Anyway, let's move on to the aforementioned 12th race here as we bring on the Colts and Geldings and the 2-year-old $100,000 Proud Man. And my initial point was Safi winning three races here 4 Saturdays ago on August 3rd. I mean, the real capper to the day was not only Chancet, of course, running away and hiding in the Fager. It was the fact that they had a Colt by commissioner in Shooting Star in Safi and Island Commish. And although his last race got rained off, I mean, he buried that field.
He buried that field by 9.5 lengths and was in for a claiming tag. So he was like, they didn't know what they had. Maybe with the off track, no one jumped in and grabbed this horse. So Island Commish was very impressive. Let's see if this horse, you got to answer some questions today. Got to do it on the turf. I used Graceful Kitten and Montfort in third. But Island Commish right on top of my ticket for that performance.
And I'm going into this thinking they wanted turf all along. Maiden claiming field or maiden claiming debut or not, they wanted turf for this colt, who is out of a Sligo Bay Dam. And speaking of pedigrees, the 10 Traveling Gambler is by that underrated turf stallion as far as I see things, and it's my lucky day. Eddie Plesa runs that one from the outside. It's funny, unlike the Philly race, Ronnie, where you've got Champagne Humor and Fujiara, who have run fine on the turf, in fact, better than fine, there's really not a lot of turf pedigree among the more shorter price contenders in the Proud Man.
And then there's a race where we both have the 7 on top, but I would suggest you look at this race. If you can find somebody you like, add him to your Rainbow 6 or your late pick 5 ticket, or even a late pick 4.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, the turf listed is good, and we'll hit the green stuff in races 10 and 12, and we'll cash things out and certainly cap what will be a very abbreviated Labor Day weekend with Hurricane Dorian. We got to batten down the hatches and all that stuff, but we end things with the $200,000 Affirm. You've got Chancet, a monster favorite on the morning line as he looks for his third consecutive win, 2-5 for Safi Joseph and Edgar Zayas. And just pulling apart the great history we have in the Florida Sire Series, Ronnie, when you start to get into the nitty-gritty of who has passed through this series, mainly even the middle leg, the $200,000 Affirm, that winner's list, rather, is a proverbial who's who. There are some terrific horses there.
Yeah, and Chancet has a chance to join the ranks of impressive horses. He's been that way. And look, Darter and Tie, 3 rules. Garden Tie just last year, and that is Garden Tie winning in there. But you go further down. There's my horse, Mecki. We keep mentioning this every day. And, of course, the inaugural winner, Smile.
Yeah, Smile was a sprint champion, yeah. I mean, down the road. In fact, Big Drama would go on to win a Breeders' Cup sprint and be a sprint champion for our good buddy and trainer David Fox. And we'll see if Chancet can write himself right onto that list of terrific Florida breds of yesteryear. And in the case of Chancet, he's been so good. He's obviously created quite a bit of buzz, and we're thankful and privileged to have him stabled at this time of the year with us in South Florida. And any doubt, any reservations that I personally had that maybe his maiden win was just this aberrationally giant effort, were put to rest last time out, again, back on that August 3rd opening round of the Florida Sire Stakes. Chancet was never given a breather. The two-man with a plan who was outside went, would not let him off the rail, and Edgar Zayas had to use him, but in the end, it didn't matter. This was a taxing trip, but Chancet ran fast and was just so good.
Yeah, so good. He gave paired up a pair of 91 buyers in this race right here, and as you mentioned, was had now a lot of people saying, well, he drifted in the stretch, he got tired, but he had a reason to get tired. He was hounded early on, so he's good. I can't wait to see him run a little later on this afternoon, and we'll see if this single comes to fruition for everybody who singles this horse in the Rainbow Six. And there you see him just going.
Well, look how he travels as well. I mean, that's one of the real appeals of this horse. I mean, he seemingly has all the intangibles and checks one box after another. When you watch how easy of a time he has. has just covering ground, and it's hard to imagine, as all these horses have to go 7 furlongs on the dirt today. The stretch from 6 to 7, and you'll hear Edgar Zayas talk about it a bit later in the day, doesn't seem to pose an issue, just the makeup of this horse with how efficient he can move.
Yeah, so we'll see how he does. You know, that's always been the stopper. After 7, they go to 1 mile and 1/16, but I think chance, it's his race to lose, absolutely.
Yeah, no, he is without a doubt the star of the show, and the man that will be calling each and every of the 13 races on the card, our good buddy Pete Aiello, and your good buddy, he's standing by upstairs with those scratches and changes on this Saturday, August 31st.
The best chance for success begins with a solid foundation.